homecoming for me, being back at Cal. I was obviously hired by Coach Esker, and you know, we went through a lot together in those 4 years, kind of coming back from the program being cut, and I was you know, hired basically right after that happened to you know, go into a regional the last year, and then having a chance to coach at ULP in the West Coast Conference the last 2 years. Being back here, I'm with Matt Ledresh, who I coached as a freshman at Cal, recruited him, recruited most of the team, or a lot of the team that's at Cal right now. So, you know, a different dynamic as far as coming back and having a better feel probably for this, a little easier transition for me, and probably for the guys as well, who kind of know my personality, and I know their families a little bit, and I know them as players as well. So, so that's made it a lot easier. I think our team, you know, fortunately, you know, Coach Esker did a great job, you know, getting a younger team that we had recruited, and they played a lot last year. So there's not a lot of mystery as far as, you know, what our team is. A lot of these guys played. Our rotation, we have changed a little bit up there. We'll have Jared Horn on Friday, Joey Matulovich on Saturday. Both those guys have started, and as well as Matt Ledresh. But we're going to do similar to what Rusty had talked about with having one of our better guys get in the back end with Tanner Dodson, who has experience starting. But I think it just gives us a better back-end bullpen with him and senior Eric Martinez that will be really, you know, give us a chance with a lot of experience and some dynamic pitching in the back end. So we probably recruited him as a starter, but we feel like that's probably our best bet now. Our lineup is going to revolve around Andrew Vaughn, who's on Team USA. If I'm game planning for our team, I'm trying to figure out how to you know, make sure he doesn't beat us. So we have to make sure we put him in position to do well and be successful. Fortunately, Tanner Dodson was the Cape Cod batting champ. He's a switch hitter. We have a chance to potentially hit him behind Andrew and protect him a little bit versus some right-left matchups. And I think that could be an option for us, but we have most of our team returning. You know, so we'll just kind of have to figure out the best fit for that. Our probably one position battle is third base. We have probably played a couple freshmen there and maybe moved some guys positionally around. Corey Lee's a backup catcher. He swung the bat really well for us, and we've actually played him there. He's got a very strong arm and has done okay there, so he may get some time there. And our one freshman that could be an impact guy is Darren Baker, Dusty Baker's son, who is a very good player. He's going to probably play a lot of second base, and he can swing the bat. He's a good runner, and it probably goes without saying that he's got a pretty good feel for the game. Being around a big league clubhouse for most of his life. I would say that's kind of the base of our team. You know, Matt can probably fill you in a little bit as far as just, you know, the differences and kind of what things are with us, but it's pretty cut and dry, which makes it easy for me.
Thanks, Coach. Questions?
Well, Matt, what have been the biggest differences with the coaching turnover here?
I mean, I think like Mike said that a lot. We kind of hit the ground running, kind of started where we left off. I mean, Mike being here my freshman year and kind of being a part of the culture with Coach Esker and whatnot, it was a really pretty seamless transition. And, you know, we've been really lucky to have that seamless transition, and it allowed us to kind of formulate practice plans very easily and have a great fall. You know, just a lot of familiarity amongst the coaching staff and the players. Whether it's the recruiting and just, you know, playing together.
Two of the coaches that were there with me were with Coach Esker at times too. Pat Shine was there for a period of time, and then Noah Jackson as well. So, you know, we have three coaches that these guys are familiar with as well. So it makes that, from every standpoint, makes it a lot easier.
Matt, some guys on the team have gone through a lot of stuff this offseason, be it the fires or with Jared. How has that brought you guys as a team, as players, together?
Yeah, it's starting with the fire, it was tough. I mean, you know, we had a couple guys on our team lose grandparents' homes and have to evacuate, and it was tough. The Jared thing was tough. But we were there for the whole time. You know, we were up there visiting with him, checking in with his family, and we've been with him every step of the way, and it's you know, he's doing real well, and you know, we're here for him. So it was tough. But.
Coach, where is Dodson going to play when he's not pitching?
He'll be in center field. Yeah, so he'll play center field. We'll bring him right in from center to pitch in, you know, the back end, whether it's the eighth or ninth inning. I think between the seventh, eighth, and ninth inning with Martinez and Dodson, we'll try to figure out some combination of that to have those guys shorten the game for us a little bit. And I think if they're, you know, on, they should be pretty solid. I think the pitching staff last year, I mean, there's a lot of experience and a lot of young guys pitched, and probably, you know, as Coach Esker went through it last year with these guys, statistically it probably wasn't the best year, but there are a lot of guys that have the experience and have a chance to make some jumps, and I think they have done that just through pitching in games, where maybe in some other years they wouldn't pitch as much, so I think we do have a chance to make a jump there. But we are probably, it is probably our spot where we are statistically the weakest from last year.
Does Dusty come around the program much? Have you picked his brain? Have you had a chance to pick his brain and stuff?
Yeah, I'm surprised I still have a job, actually. Yeah, he's around quite a bit. I do. Anytime I get a chance, I mean, between him and Bob Melvin being alumni, I'm trying to soak it in as much as I can, you know, because they are both around quite a bit. So it is pretty cool. It's a unique situation where you got those guys around. You have a chance to, you know, just talk baseball with them and understand. I mean, obviously the professional game's a lot different, but, you know, there are, you know, it's baseball. There's a lot of similarities, you know, there's a lot of information, there's a lot of knowledge between those two guys, and anytime I get a chance to soak it in, I do that.
How often is Bob around, other than, like, before basketball games when he gets there early?
Yeah, I mean, we've done some events, you know, some donor events and alumni events, and then he has at almost every basketball game. You know, so if I get a chance to, you know, hang out with him a little bit, he's around more than I expected.
What specifically has Dusty and Bob imparted upon you?
I don't know if it's anything specific. You know, I think it's just probably talking baseball. I mean, we've talked a lot about analytics in the pro game, and, you know, obviously there's a lot of shifts and a lot of different things, and maybe how that can translate with, you know, less amount of data in the college level. Just talking about, you know, positions and just recruiting, just different things, makeup of players. You know, I would say nothing specific, but just, you know, talking about the game and trying to understand, you know, where they're coming from and what their experience is. But, you know, I think just a variety of things.
We'd also have Marcus Simeon and Mark Hanna around every day working out in the offseason. It's been really cool. I know, you know, they've taught our hitters, our pitcher, but our hitters have learned so much from them, just watching the way they work and work on their swing. And so, aside from those two, having those two around too has been really cool for us.
You kind of play with a chip on your shoulder, knowing it wasn't that long ago when baseball was pretty much done at Cal and you had to revive it. Kind of like, you never forget that.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think it's definitely a special place for the fact that, you know, you have a lot of alumni involved. You have a lot of people with deep roots that are involved in the program financially and then just a part of the program for support. You know, so you have a situation here where, you know, the players understand that how much that this program means to a lot of people, you know, and I think you do have a little bit of chip on your shoulder, and you have the right type of guys at Cal that, you know, play for that a little bit and understand that, and it does have a deeper meaning, and when you're around it and you're in it, you have an appreciation for it, and I think the players really know that, and it does mean something. I think it means a lot.
Anything else? Coach, thank you.